In this video, we're going to talk about the most common measure of central tendency, the arithmetic mean. As a measure of central tendency, the mean is designed to help us determine the midpoint of a data set. The mean comes in two forms. We have a population mean and a sample mean. Both the population and sample mean serve the same purpose, but they differ in one substantial area. The term population is used to reflect all of the values in a data set. For example, let's say we wanted to know the mean SAT score for all incoming students at a four-year university. In order to calculate this, we would need to solve for the population mean since we're studying the SAT scores for all incoming students and not just a select few. To be thorough, let me provide another example. Say we're trying to determine the mean net income of firms within an industry. Again, we would solve for the population mean because we're using the net income of all firms within the industry. Now, the way that we calculate the population mean, which is reflected as mu, is by dividing the sum of all the values in the population by the number of values in that population. This sort of E-shaped symbol is known as sigma, and it represents the sum of. X reflects the values in the population, while N reflects the actual number of values in that population. Looking at our data set, we have a list of monthly home sale prices in a market. Since we're looking at all of the selling prices within a market, we know that we need to compute the population mean. The first thing that we need to do is add up all of the values in the population, which is reflected by the Greek letter sigma. The sum of our monthly home sale prices is $2,225,000. The next step is to divide the sum of our population values by the number of values in our population. Counting the number of values in our population, we know that we have 8 values. Now, we divide the $2,225,000 by 8, which produces a population mean of $278,125. So the mean of our population, or the approximate center of the data set, is $278,125. Although similar to the population mean, the sample mean provides the approximate center of a sample of values, meaning we don't have all of the values in a data set, and instead have only a subset of the entire population. This is fairly common when conducting market research, since it's often not feasible to obtain data from an entire population. Instead, we try to make sure that our sample closely matches the characteristics of our population so that we can draw conclusions about the overall population. To calculate the sample mean, we divide the sum of the values in our sample, which is expressed by sigma x, by the number of values in our sample, which is expressed by n. You'll notice that although the variables have changed, the procedure for calculating a population and sample mean is the same. Let's walk through a quick example and solve for a sample mean. Let's say that we're attempting to discover the average wait time from when a customer first stands in line to when they pay and are handed a receipt. Instead of observing every single transaction, we decide to obtain a sample by observing wait times in several stores. Looking at the table in the bottom right corner of your screen, we first need to sum up each wait time, which is expressed in seconds. Then we divide the number of values in our transaction, which is 12, to get our sample mean. Now, one of the things you're probably noticing is that 12 values is hardly a significant sample size, and we'll probably lose the ability to draw conclusions. But we're not going to worry about that until future videos. In our next video, we'll go beyond the arithmetic mean and discuss how to calculate the weighted mean. If you want more from Alanis Business Academy, you can subscribe to our channel, download our podcast, which you can find on iTunes, Stitcher, and TuneIn, or go to alanisbusinessacademy.com. Thanks for watching.